So in respect of it, like what we did was we tried finding out some things related to our program. So we wrote this kind of program, and then we identified, okay, how exactly the identifiers can be defined, what are the different mechanisms that can be used to define the variable depending upon the number of bytes required for that particular variable. Correct. So it can go further with respect to this DQ DT2, and which we are going to make use of in this semester rather. Similarly, we talked about some read-only data kind of stuff, okay, which can be added with dot RO data. If at all there are some uninitialized variables or identifiers, we said this would be kind of a mechanism by which we definitely would be say probably reserving number of bytes required depending upon what is the size. Correct. Similarly, we tried writing one program which was like printing the things. So we saw like how exactly this printf and putf can be used. So what kind of difference is there in respect of using making use of them rather. Right. So like generally it is suggested. So let me show you the thing, like why I introduced you both the things like printf and as well as putf thing. So let me write, say for example, today's programs 8101.asm. Okay, here this would be related to making use of putf. So let me write. Section dot let me take RO data. Okay, then let us print a message db. This is a sample. Okay, then we will use the section dot text global main extern putf main move sorry push as we said msg call putf, and for every push, as we said, every push would be comprising 4 bytes. Fine. So ultimately if number of pushes are 1, then you are going to write 4 multiplied by 1, so this will be 4. Fine. So let me write another program similarly, where instead of putf now I would be preferring to make use of say printf. Okay, so I am simply making this change. Okay, so let us see the bytes perspective. So we can see 120, 182 and 188 bytes. So probably like these would be the kind of things rather which you may use. 1 minute, change owner. Okay, now like we have these programs written. Okay, so 2 and 3 ASM. So if I write 2 dot ASM, sorry, not 2, cat 0810 underscore 01 dot ASM. Cat 0801.asm and 02.asm. What is the difference here? You may see like we are using only like at one place we used printf, at other place we are using putf. So let us create an executable for both of them. So nasm-felf32 and then our program name. Okay, similarly, other one. So let us see the size. So you can see that it took same number of bytes. Okay, right now, though we had like in object code rather, I'm talking about object code perspective. It took only like same number of bytes, though the inclusion that you had with respect to the code, okay, was the difference in both of them was in respect of like printf and putf, some characters. So the source file may have some difference in terms of like what would be the size. So source file had change in number of bytes to be 6, but we do not worry mainly about the source file, we do worry about this. So let us now create gcc dash m 32081.o. Now I'm writing a specific file name. This is executable that I'm creating. Similarly, for my another file, I'm creating this separate one. So let us see. Now see the size perspective. Fine, 15436. Now, if I use, say, for example, there is a command called nm. Now, this nm does what? This nm shows you the different symbols used in your object file. 1 minute. Seems I lost the connection of laptop. Okay, so this nm lists the symbols of from object file. So if we see, the size for both the file is same in this case. Okay, though we know specifically, like both of them add different things. So there is a command called nm, which we said, which it will be listing the variables that you use there. So let me show one by one. Say one. Okay, so let us see, we can see this and we can see putes in this case for one. Now, second thing, if we see, it would be printf, correct? Now, let us try and show what exactly is happening. So there is another utility called, now this nm would be listing you symbols from your object code. That's what we saw. Now, what if I really wish to see what happens at at execution level? Okay, so like if I have to use another say utility available, so it is called as man stress. Okay, so this would be the kind of utility that helps you out to trace system calls and signals. Now, in operating system course as well as in systems course, we saw that there are the importance of system calls is too much. Like whenever we as a programmer or we as a user do interact with the system, or wish to interact with the system, operating system, rather, we definitely require help of the system calls. And if system calls are there, then ultimately we can enter into system area or kernel area, what generally is referred at that level. Correct. So If I have to see what different system calls are used, so let me write this one. Suppose I write C for one. Sorry, I have to write dot slash because it is executable. Now you will see that it is making use of a write system call. Correct? And it is displaying that slash n2. Fine, it is making use of write system call. Now this was for file one, correct? Now let me use it for file two. Now in that case as well, like slash n was not specifically printed there. This was for printf, correct? So let me show you like on what basis I'm saying this. So if I write say for now the code that we use, so let me first see this. So the code I'm using is this 02. Fine. So let us see the code here. So less 08102.asm. Now, if you see, we are making use of printf. Correct? We use printf there. Now, while we use printf, it is making use of only write system call once. Correct? For this case. Are you with me? Now, the difference that I showed you that day, like what printf and putS is doing. Now, we are seeing that from operating system perspective. Now, let me show you the another code, which was for 1.asm. Okay, so it is making use of putS. Fine, so let us see that one. Now, you will see here, like though it printed this write, using write system call, this is sample. It is making use of another write. Okay, another write for slash n. So this is purposefully added by putS. And like this is suggested, it is suggested rather every time when you use a printf to print a simple message like this or simple text like this, which doesn't contain any say %d, %s kind of stuff. Always you should prefer making use of putS. Now let me show you why I am saying so. Okay, this was mandated because your code at some level written in C would be translated into say what you can call it as executable at that time. When it runs on the system level, it would be making use of putS only. So let me show you sample.c. Okay, now in this code I am writing a C code purposefully, and then I am using printf. This is a sample putS. Let me write this is a sample, and let us see what exactly is happening at that side. So let us skip the warnings. Okay, now there is no error for a while. Fine. Now if I write this dot slash a dot out, you saw earlier I used first thing was printf and then second one was putS. Fine. Now if I really see the source code created, the assembly code created by your assembly code output created by your compiler. Okay, let us see the code. So I used this dash s to generate an assembly code, ls-ltr. Oh, sorry, I use small s. It should be capital S to generate an assembly code. So if I write this, let us see the code. Now we recall we used printf at both the places. Sorry, at one place printf, you can see this. At one place putS. Correct? At one place putS. Now both of them we are using only to display the message. Okay, so internally when we do apply and when we do execute the code, you will see that. Okay, I don't think I have created an executable. Yeah. So if I say s trace dot slash a dot out. Fine. Let me maximize this. So you will see that it is making use of write. And only one write is used, though both the strings are there. Now, can somebody tell me why? What was the reason for making use of only one write, though there were two things? One call was for printf, other call was for putS. And why it is so, like why it is showing us only one write? Okay, to clear your issue, let me change the order. I will change this order. Okay, now let me create again an executable. So there is no error, warning, correct? Or even warnings are there, we will skip them. So let us execute this. Now you will see there are two writes. I never added slash n in my code. If I see sample.c, I never added slash n in my code. Correct. But when we traced it, we can see that it added this. Now this is to be intelligently used by us rather when, because simply we always make use of printf. Okay, but you may say one character would be extra printed in this case. Like for example, 17 and 16 number of characters printed are, for putters it is 17 and for printf it is 16. So I haven't used any say for a while, what you can call it as slash n. Correct, but both of them would be ending at this. So why to add one more character in your source? Because anyway, it would be added there ultimately. Correct? Ultimately, it would be added there. Then why should we go with, in what manner we should decide whether to make use of printf or whether to make use of putters? This will be the kind of challenge every C programmer may have to face at a particular level when we are talking about optimization. Now, our idea about code optimization is that size of code always gets minimized. No. Code optimization means simplicity in execution, and that's what this putters is doing for you. It is making your life simple, very, very simple. Now you may say, how? Because if I use, if I have to print like value of x is percent %d, I cannot use that kind of stuff into my putters. I can never. But when I do see, for example, a message or any string that I wanted to print in a C code, which doesn't contain any format specifier, like this percent %d, percent %t, C, percent %s, then ultimately it is always should be my first choice to make use of putters whenever I'm using or whenever I am printing the string. And it definitely, like internally, it would be using printf and putters. So like what we did here is we tried printing it through the different codes. Like for example, we created two files, these ones. One of them is using putters, another one is printf. Can I write the similar code by making use of directly write system call? Because we saw what are the executables that we created? Okay. Say, for example, if I say a trace, you can see that it is making use of write system call, correct? For this, even if I use say, for second, it is making use of write system call. Then why should I use at all putters or printf? Why not I use write system call directly? Now, how to use this write system call? So let us try to address that part mainly. Please keep attention because this would be really important for us to know. Okay, what is the difference at that point of time? Okay, so let us see like where exactly these system calls are defined. Okay, so let me go to root user. Goes to this usr include asm. Okay, depending upon your system, you might see an i386 directory instead of asm. Fine. Then simply write unistd 32 because we are working with 32-bit system. So 32.h. If you, sorry, not cd, less. Display the contents, less. These all are your system call numbers. So for example, write 4, read 3, fork 2, exit 1, open, close, create, link, unlink, and so on. So many system calls are there. You can simply go below. See, these many system calls or signals are used internally by your system whenever we are making a 32-bit system. So 4, 3, 5. Now, how can I use this system call? Right. So if I write like man write, now you simply will see that this write was from general command manual, from shell. It showed it as this write. If I have to see the write system call, then I have to write man to write. Now, how should I define this? Whether it is one or two. So if you write man, man, you will see somewhere these are the manual sections, total 9 sections in your manual. You may have to install these all sections. Automatically, they may not be taken. So whenever I am making use of any system calls, so they should be from second section. Now, if I write man ls, say for a while, man ls, it shows me this one. This one tells me that it is user command. Similarly, if I write man write, it tells me that it is from general commands manual. Okay, and if I write man to write, then this is a system call. Sorry. Okay, so it tells me write to a file descriptor. Now, when we printed it, let us see this. There are three parameters that write system call takes. It is defined into this unistd.h file. Write int fd. So like, for example, you must have written C code. So you always used file, capital file *fp like this way. So you wrote like this while writing any file processing command. So this fp was small. What is this fp, by the way? File pointer. Okay. Have you ever seen what exactly this file pointer tells? Don't tell me it is a file pointer, means it is pointing to a file. What type of data that it holds? You will say then it is a pointer, that means an address, that means a number. So ultimately, yes, it is a number associated with every file. So every file on your system is known by the number, some ID. Like we saw with processes, there is a process ID, correct? How do you see that process ID? So if you write PS dash, say for example, A, so this number, actually this 20457 or any number here in the first column tells you that it is a process ID, process number. Correct? It is a process number. Now, if it is process number, similarly, how do I know then what is the number of for my file? Because this says file integer fd. So whenever you are referring to this file star fp, it is referring to number. So ls that il, let us write this. This I means inode, where your system is identified by this number. Sorry, your file is identified by this number. So maybe those who are interested in entering into systems as their profession, or maybe companies like NVIDIA point of view, you should read Maurice Bach book, Design of Unix Operating System, where you will understand what exactly this number is trying to tell us. This is an I number which is by which your file is identified. Similarly, like if I write this dot, when we wrote this yesterday, dot slash a dot out. What is this one then? If it is FD, like while we saw write system call, first parameter it said was file descriptor. See this. Then it had a string to be printed, and then lastly how many characters are to be printed. So see here, it printed 16 characters because slash n was added. It printed 17 characters, 16 and 17, correct? Depending upon the file that you use, that you tried printing. See here, the string that you tried printing, so 17 and 16. Now what this one signifies us, let us try to see where exactly this is defined. Let me go to unistd.h. Let me go into the file called unistd.h. Okay, not here, but outside. Okay, now let me show you what that one signifies us, what one significantly tells us. Okay. I'm going below. Yeah. So these are your standard file descriptors. Standard input, 0. Standard output, std out, that's what you say, na? Std out. The standard output device is known by one. So when we wrote this stress, it says, I am going to display this string on standard output. And that's what it shows us when we wrote. It was there. CD. Yeah. So when I wrote this, it displayed on the standard output of this code. Okay, this is sample. So that one significantly tells us that it is standard output. So now, if at all I have to write this code in assembly using system call. So we saw both the cases. Like for example, when we said this, we created these executables. The assembly code that we wrote for putS and printf, and this C was together. So you can see very small differences there in terms of size. But what if I write the same code to display the string using assembly, using, for example, a system call? Now, how can I do this? Okay, so side by side, I would be showing you the information about the system calls. So let us write section dot data. So display string using write system call directly instead of making use of printf and putS. Now you have to make sure, like whenever you are using printing any message which doesn't contain any format specifier, I suggest you to make use of this function, okay, or this kind of code. Section.row data, msg, db, we will take same string. This is a sample. Fine. Okay, now let us say section.text, global main. Now we have to write system call. How should I go about it? So let us go here. So we saw, or we said rather, like for example, let me go to this usr include sudo dash s less unistd.h. Okay, not unistd.h, but man write. man to write. So we wanted first parameter to be file descriptor, second parameter to be the string to be printed, and third parameter is size. Right? Size, how many characters are to be printed. On the similar line, we said, okay, we tried finding out what is the system call number for write system call. So what is the system call number here? 4. Fine. So let us use it. Now, whenever you are making use of system call, whenever one uses system call, use registers as described below. Okay. Now, first thing, whatever your system call number is, you add it with EAX. Because we are using write system call, correct? Now, move EBX. Now, what was your first number for that write system call? What was the first parameter for write system call? Let us see, man to write. It says file descriptor. And in that file, cd dot dots, okay, let us say less dot dot slash unistd.h. Less unistd.h. So if I see what was the number for standard output, it was 1. Correct? That's why I would be using here 1. So this is first parameter value of system call. So you have to use this register only. Okay. Then ECX comma, what you wanted to print? MSG. So you write here MSG. So this is second parameter value of system call. Now there is a third parameter. What was the third parameter? It was like we gave this buffer. Now we wanted size count. Okay. Now you can see here. Let us see where exactly. Writes up count bytes. What is the number of bytes that you want to print from the buffer starting at BUF, the file referred to by file descriptor. Fine. So how exactly we will compute size of this text now? Now you may say, let me count it. So for example, if I go here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. So I will write probably 16 here. But will it be always possible for me to read number of characters? Probably no. Okay. So this would be what? Now what is to be done for this? We'll talk after a while. This is third parameter. Now, how your system will know that you want to call the system call? You should communicate to the system. Now, I am using this EAX is containing 4. That means I want to execute the system call. So let us see. You write here 0x80. Now, what exactly this 0x80 is? Now, this 80 contains like it is kind of say multi-dimensional table. I'm not saying only 1 or 2. It definitely for a while is a multi-dimensional table. I don't know, probably until and unless I as a programmer enter into system's code, kernel's code, I would not be able to find out what exactly this 80 contains. Definitely 80 contains this. Like this 80, whenever I'm using, what are the numbers that we saw from 10 to 4 plus, 400 plus? all those system calls can be handled from the user side using this interrupt. So this 80 is a value picked from, this is an instruction that you have to use, to be used to execute interrupt correct. So the all those system calls which we listed there into UniSTD, like for example UniSTD underscore 32.h, all of them can be executed under this category. Fine. Now don't write anything. You have not, you are not expected to write now external or something like this. Now this case I am writing for a while with respect to by counting this manually 16. Okay. Now what can be done later? We will see after a while. Okay. So let us go back to our code. Let us try to translate this. So this is our code which we wrote. Simply. Now if I see ls08*.asm-ltr. Now this third, you will see, okay, seems look like it is taking some number of bytes to be more because we added some comments there. Okay, so never worry about your size of the source code. Okay, so let us try to translate this nasm-aplf32-08-10-03.asm. Fine. Now if I see similarly this size for object code, see the size, this was with system call earlier, it was 624, correct? Now certainly it got decreased. Can you see? Because I'm directly using write system call, I'm moving out the hurdle. Like for example, see, you are using C code uses C function when executable gets created at that time is replaced by the system call for better interaction with the system. Better interaction work for the system. Okay, so let us create an executable now. So gcc-m32-083.o-o-083. Fine. Now let me see even a size. See the size of executable. 436. Now certainly it became 404. Now you will see what is the achievement here. We could successfully save 32 bytes. Then is this a big matter rather? You may not realize that right now. You definitely will realize when you are working in industry, when you have to really worry about, okay, I have this limited memory. How can I use it? How can I execute my code within that line? So now if I write this stress, okay, let me first execute this this line, this code which we created. What happened? Has it printed anything? Why not? What might be the reason? Let us see. Emacs. It is maybe. Okay, let us do this. So see the code. EAX, EBX, ECX, EDX and AT. Section.txt, global main. Okay. Let us try generating this code, NASM, GCC. So actually it is trying to print it because we haven't added any slash and specifier probably. Okay. Or let us write this zero. Let us add one more parameter there. Okay, now you will see why it displayed them 10. What was the reason? Like it is printing both the things because it was in flush. Something is stored inside the memory. Like for example, it added one more character as T, which was not there earlier. So then it may confuse my code. What exactly to be used? So we used this is a sample. Correct? And then I'm using this. So maybe let me do this one thing. Let me add 10 as well. NASM GCC. Now, because there is something is there always in the buffer, whatever the buffer that it is taking, something is taken by it, probably. So what I can do then for to remove this kind of issue? Okay, so let us see. Now I will write LENEQU $-MHG. And here instead of EDX, 17, I will write len. Fine. Let us see. Was there any change? Okay, then you may see. Okay, so something misbehavior occurring due to the code that is written. Okay, so let us do this -g -fdwarf. So this would be for debugging the file. Okay, then similarly do this for fdwarf, and then you write gdb./3. Now you can see reading symbols from towards bottom. Correct. Let us write breakpoint main. So let us run the code. So you can see the values, like you write display $EX, display $EBX, display $ECX, display $EDX. Okay, run. Next, EX4, EBX1, ECX is getting address. So if I try displaying this value, $ECX. You can see the text. This S displays examine contents of address specified by ECX, display it as a string. That's what it displayed. Okay, now let us see what is the length here. 4 + 1 = 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. Correct. So this is EDX. See, let us see what it contains. So total number of characters, because we added 10 and so on, correct? Zero is also there. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. And that /0 added there. You can see here. We added this /0. This 10 was added as slash and there, correct? This zero was there. That's why that 18 was there. So if I continue with the code, it is going to execute this. It came out. Correct? Now you will see it is not displaying us that line. What are the text that was supposed to be displayed? It is not displaying that line. Why? What might be the reason then in this case? It actually displayed it there. But due to the process scheduling that is happening, what is to be shown? That the output was not displayed in front of you. It is not shown to you, correct? It should have showed us this. This is a sample ultimately there, but it is not showing us this thing. Correct? So let me start one more time. Run. Next instruction. Next instruction, next instruction. Now it is executing this code. Okay, so INT 80 was executed right now. So it entered into that code. Now you can see few things changed. Okay, when it comes out of it, let us see what exactly happens there. It never showed us that because we are trying to print, then whether should I use it or not? This would be definitely a question in front of us. Actually, the output was printed. That's what it is showing us. So there is a buffer issue that is happening with the system, at least on my system right now, to whom the chance be given. It actually it is displaying it twice. So what I can do then to remove this? So let me do one thing. Emacs 0803.asm. So I will use exit system call. So exit system call is move EX comma 1 int 0x80. So this is exit. On what basis I decide this is exit? Let us see. What is the number for exit? 1. Correct? So let us see this. I'm saving this code. I'm coming out of it. Now let me create an executable. NASM GCC. Okay, let me do this stress. Where is my write? Why it is not showing me that write at all? Correct? In the code, it should have added that write value there. Then have I made any change? Have I made any mistake then with respect to printing the contents? Because it is not showing me my write function at all. Where is write? I cannot find or locate it. Okay, so let us see. 3.asm. Then have I made any mistake there in terms of making use of these system calls? So when I use this, then ultimately it is showing me something, some misbehavior is applied internally with respect to the code. What are the code that is written? Correct? What are the code that is written at that point of time? So how can I get that then write system call working? Okay. Can somebody suggest me what might be happening here? So you, hint I am giving you, if you have used Turbo C rather, you always used a function called fflush. What is that fflush? What is that flush function? Yes, please. What is that first flush function? Are you there?
Yes, sir.
Okay. What is flush function?
Sir, I haven't used it.
Okay. Anybody there like who used it earlier? Here, I'm using this EX, but EBX is containing some value. Correct, because you always wrote exit 0. So let me write then. Okay, I should write here EBX comma 0 because it was now I'm taking you towards that flush. Okay, so EBX comma 0. Let me see like if it can help me out on this front. NASM GCC and then your code. Okay, let me go into then executing this 083. Breakpoint main, run. Next instruction. What is the reason why it is not displaying my output?
Sir, how the program is going to know that it is executing the right system call?
Yes, because we wrote INTAT 0x80. Correct? We wrote it because otherwise it could not have exited from that code. Na? Like, dekho yahan par, wo exit hua na? Exited normally. Ye code execute hone ke baad. It exited normally. Okay, suppose if I remove that. उसको हम कमेंट डाल देते हैं. इफ आई पुट कमेंट हियर सेमी कोलन करके इसको रिमूव करते हैं. ओके, फिर से कंपाइल, सॉरी असेंबल, लिंक, डिबग, इसको रन करते हैं. तो ये जो एग्जिटेड नॉर्मली है और जो ऊपर भी था, इन दोनों में कुछ फर्क दिखता है क्या हमें? प्रोसेस आईडी छोड़ दो, जो प्रोसेस आईडी दिखा रहा है ना उसको छोड़ दो. करेक्ट, प्रोसेस आईडी माइट बी डिफरेंट बट इट इज टेलिंग अस एक्चुअली इट इज मेकिंग यूज ऑफ दैट एग्जिट देयर. इज आवर कोड. Or do I have to make some changes in the system rather, which can lead to what exactly I am trying to take, what I am exactly trying to achieve the things? Because if I write NM for a while, it will let me know what variables I have used there. Okay, let us take that for object code. It can tell us there is something length, main, and message. Now, if I try to remove it by the system perspective, okay, so like it definitely can display the value rather. Fine. So if I write this, 08. Let me write this echo $?. It is returning me 0. This is a return value. What are the return that was added by us? So in this case, this, it is not able to print it. It is not able to print it on the screen. That's what, like, if I go to man to write, it says write to file descriptor and return value is the number of bytes it printed. But one can see it is not able to print that at all over there. Okay. It is not able to print that at all. The reason being, probably, the reason might be hidden into our code. Why it is not able to display it? We are having 4, which is system call number. Correct. Then we took EBX, we took ECX, we took EDX, we took interrupt AT. Now, when these things are to be used, then ultimately,
are we following a specific sequence so that we can execute a system call?
This is the sequence.
Okay, EX. So we can't write EX, 4 after the EBX, 1.
You know, okay, by that way you are talking about, it can shuffle, no problem. It only knows what registers are to be used in what order.
Okay.
Okay, so even if you make the change in the changes in the instruction order, that should not be a problem.
So our first parameter will be in EAX and second will be in EBX, like this.
Okay, let me tell you, EAX would be containing always a system call number. Okay, EBX would be first parameter, ECX would be second parameter, and EDX would be third parameter. As per write system call, there are three parameters. It is a file descriptor, so that's why we wrote because it is standard output, correct? ECX would be the message that we want to print, and this is the message that we added there, correct? So, like, let us put a command, comment, okay? Let us write, say, for example, msg db asdf, okay, for a while. Now, I'm simply making the one change to see whether can I get something better. SM GCC can I see any change? Definitely not. Okay, so like even for example, as per what Vishesh said, let me make the change. I changed the jumbled the order. Okay, I jumbled the order. Let us see. NASM GCC output. So if I write echo dollar dash, it is displaying me zero. It is somewhere failing to print on the standard output device. It is not able to do this. Reason might be anything. So if I add zero, NASM GCC output. Return value should be length, and that's what it is. It is showing us it couldn't print. Maybe some issue with respect to the operating system perspective. So maybe if you have machines available with you, why not try this code? Okay, on your machine. So let me send it through the chat, this particular code, so that you can try at your end. So I'm sending these three codes for you and the C code. Okay, try these codes and see, and try to find out what exactly is happening at that side. Okay, so that we can address these things rather in our next session. Okay, what exactly is expected to be done by us if at all I have to make use of particularly the calls. Okay,
sir, I have one more doubt.